So now we will see, so coils connected in series. Coils connected in series, so which is having some mutual inductance M. Right. So let us assume that we have some iron core is there. So it is wound by two windings. So this winding one and this is winding two. Okay. So let us assume that, so it is having a self inductance LA and it is having self inductance LB, and in between, so there is a mutual inductance M is between these two coils. So let us assume that, so these two, the current I is passing here, the current I is passing here, and this is connected here. So this is series connection, right? So that means the same current I is also passing here. So we have another one. So same current I is passing here. So this is current I is passing here. Right. So in this, so instead of that, so this is connected here. Okay. So the current is connected here. You understand the difference?
This is parallel connection.
Why it is parallel? It's not parallel, right? Series connection.
Anti-series,
right? That's correct. So this is anti-series.
Sir, why is it anti-series? Because it's still connected like in a single circuit, right?
Yes, thank you. Yes.
So could you once again say why is it anti-series? Why is it not still in series?
See here, this is right. So this is series connection, right? So instead of that, if it is something like this, right? Okay. So this is not exactly the same thing. So it is connected to the other side. So if you notice that, so here, this mutual flux, so both are in the same direction. So whereas here, the flux is in the opposite direction. Okay. So now you will understand when you actually realize the things. Okay. So here we have some notation called as dot notation. So the dot notation, what it indicates that, so where exactly the current is entering. So here the current is entering, right? So we usually place a dot here. You are aware of this? For example, you have one coil is there. Okay. So this is, if you mention a dot means, so here the current is entering. The same thing, so if you place a dot here, so that means the current is entering like this. So this is known as dot notation. In a mathematical circuit, how the current is entering, so that matters, because so it will actually the polarity of that induced EMF that depends on the how the current is entering. So here, if a dot is placed here, so that means the current is entering, right? So here, then that means the non-dot case, if it is non-dot, right? So here the current is entering here, and the current leaving here. So whereas here, the current is entering and the current is leaving. At the dot, current is enters. At the non-dot, the current leaves. So that is the notation we normally follow.
But we already have the arrow mark, right? So if we have arrows, why do we need a dot?
So that's why if I'm not given an arrow mark, right? Okay. So this is the thing. If I'm not given anything, right?
So we are supposed to use a dot only when we are not using an arrow, or should we use both simultaneously?
Both simultaneously we can use, but you cannot use like this. Okay. Right. It should be, both should be in coherence. Right. So we usually give, so this dots, that means the current entry point. So that means this polarity is positive and this will be the negative one. That is the whole idea. So when the induced EMF is there, so this is the positive polarity and the other one is the negative polarity. So now come to our discussion. Right. So now come to our discussion. So let us assume that it is having L1. Right. So let us assume that this is the current I. So this entire thing is, let us assume this L equivalent. Right. This entire thing is, this entire setup. So that inductance is L equivalent. Right. So what is the induced EMF? So what is the induced EMF? E equivalent should be E equivalent, so that is equal to L equivalent into di by dt. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now tell me, so how many induced EMFs are present in this?
Three, sir.
Three or four?
Three.
Three or four?
Three, sir. I think four, sir.
One, two.
It is four, right? So one is the self-inductance of this L coil A. Agree? So what is that self-inductance of coil A? Due to self-inductance, EMF induced, right? So that is Lj into di by dt. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Right. So next thing is self-inductance of this coil. So Lb into di by dt. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next we have EMF induced in coil B. EMF induced in coil B. Due to the rate of change of current in coil A.
Yes, sir.
So what is that?
M into di by dt.
Right. Positive sign or negative sign?
Positive sign.
Whereas here, positive sign or negative sign?
Negative sign.
Okay. So next term, so EMF induced in coil A due to the EMF, due to the rate of change of current in coil B, sorry, EMF induced in coil B due to rate of change of current in coil A. So what is that?
Again,
so this is also same, right?
M into
di by dt. So this is also negative in case here. So if we added these, all these things, you left with Lj, Lb.
Can you say negative?
So this current is here, this current is moving in the other direction, right?
Clear? In the second anti-series one or the
this is here. Flux are aiding each other. Agree?
Sir, 1 minute again.
Here the fluxes are aiding each other, right?
In the anti-series one or series one, sir?
So here in this anti-series, So in case of this, fluxes are opposite to each other, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So there is minus here. So in this case, it is plus. That is the only difference. So you're left with di by dt.
So this is for anti-series, sir. Lb plus Lb plus 2m.
Lb plus Lb minus 2m. That's it.
Minus 2m for series one, sir.
See here, I will give you the perfect nomenclature. Please focus here. So from this, what is L equivalent? So this LA plus Lb plus 2m, right? So this is for this case.
Sir.
So what is for this case?
minus 2m.
Minus 2m.
Minus 2m. Yes, sir.
Right. Okay. So this is known as, so here the mutual flux aiding the main fluxes. So these are main flux, right? So whatever the flux produced by coil 1 and coil 2 are the main flux. So mutual flux is aiding the main flux. So whereas here the mutual flux is differentiating the main flux. So that's why it is known as, so this is known as cumulative coupling. Coupling, and this is known as differential coupling. So one is cumulative coupling and the other one is differential coupling.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, in anti-series it should be LA plus LB only, no sir? Minus
LA plus LB only, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, that is what we have written.
But you wrote minus 2m there.
So this is mutual inductance is in the opposite direction, right? See here, see the connection, right? So here the flux is entering. So this is producing plus minus minus and plus minus, right? So whereas here from the mutual point of view, so this will be minus and this will be the plus. So this will be the plus and this will be the minus, right? So that means the flux that is opposing. From the connection you can understand, right? See here, these coils are connected like this. Okay, so whereas here the coils are like
this. Yes, sir. Then one will be M di by dt, one will be minus M di by dt.
That is the thing. Now you understood, right?
Then it should cancel each other, no, sir.
So why it will cancel? So here both are eaching. So here from this point of view, so this is minus. From this point of view, so this is minus, right? It will not cancel each other.
Okay, sir.
So from this coil 1A point of view, so the induced EMF is minus. So from coil B point of view, induced EMF is, that is also minus. So both are minus M into D by dt. So this is also minus M into D. The effect is same, right? So here,
yes, sir, yes.
So from this point of view, so this is positive. From this point of view, so this is also positive. So you're left with 2M di by dt.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Simple thing. The flux lines that produced by this coil and the flux line that's produced by this coil, so both are aiding each other. So whereas here, the flux lines, so one is flowing like this and the other is trying to flow in the opposite direction. So what will happen? The net inductance or net flux lines will reduce. So therefore, net inductance will reduce. Clear? So you have any questions?
Sir.
So what you left is? Yes.
In the anti-series, won't LA and LB be in opposite directions?
No, it will be in same direction, right? So that is its self-inductance.
Sir, but the current is flowing in different directions, right? Like in the figure that you drew.
See here, from this point of view, so this is the material is same, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, no? Right. Sir, note down one problem. So now I understood, right? So one is the cumulative coupling and another one is the differential coupling. So if the mutual inductance, so this is for cumulative coupling and this is for differential coupling. So note down one problem. So when two coils are connected in series, when two coils are connected in series, their effective inductance is found to be 10 Henry. So when two coils are connected in series, so their effective inductance is found to be 10 Henry. However, when the connection to one coil are reversed, the effective inductance is 6 Henry. So their effective inductance is 6 Henry. If the coefficient of coupling is 0.6, calculate self-inductance of each coil. Calculate self-inductance of each coil and the mutual inductance.
Mutual inductance is equal to 1 Henry.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Mutual inductance is 1.
So what is L1?
So once I explain about how to consider those mutuals are in cumulative and different.
How to consider?
Means you are saying some point of view I didn't understand about.
What is the point of view? I didn't understand what's your doubt.
How you to positive sign and negative sign that about that one, sir?
So this is the one we explained here, right? See here in this. Okay. So both are currenting entering like this. Okay. So whereas here in this coil, for example, somewhere, so this is the connection. So one coil, the current is entering like this, and the other coil, the current is entering like this. Okay. So what is the EMF induced? We have some mutual inductance between these two. So here also mutual inductance between these two coils. So how they are aiding each other, so that we are understanding, right? So here, so this mutual inductance, so this is also producing some EMF induced, right? So this is positive, means, so with respect to that, the EMF induced in, so the first coil, EMF induced in first coil due to the current in second coil, so that is positive. So why? Because the current entry is same. So whereas here, the current is entering in the different direction in this case, right? So what is happening here? So EMF, this is the EMF induced here. Instead of that, so you are getting a minus sign here and plus sign here. So already displaced that. So whenever this plus is there, so dot notation will be here. So that will be the positive one.
Then
you are calculating the induced EMFs due to mutual inductance. Okay. So what is the answers for these?
25/3 and 1/3.
What is 25/3?
Self inductance.
So it is simple, right? So there are two cases are there. So that is L1 plus L2 plus or minus 2M. So one case it is 10 and the other case it is 6, right? So 10 Henry and 6 Henry. So obviously L1 plus L2 plus 2M, so that is 10, right? And L1 plus L2 minus 2M, so that is 6. So coefficient of coupling is given. So we have relation M equal to square root L1 L2.
L1 is 7.63
L1 L2, right? So k value is already given. So from that you can calculate. So k is how much? It is 0.6, right? So calculate m value. Right. So from these two equations, you can calculate L1. So how much value for L1 plus L2?
8. Sir, 8.
L1 plus 8 is 8. So from this, what is square root L1, L2?
Sir, a value of M is 1.
Value of M is 1 Henry. And L1 value?
Sir, quadratic equation is made.
How much you got?
8.63 Henry.
If you got negative roots, so in that case you can exclude that, right?
I'm getting 3.63.
Sir, LA is equal to 23/3 and LB is 1/3.
So you got, what is the final expression you got? So you have two equations, right? So MA is 1 Henry. So from that, what is the relation? What is L1, L2? What is square root L1, L2?
5/3.
5/3. What is square root L1, L2? It is 1/0.6, right? Agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have another one, L1 plus L2. So that is 8. So from this L1 plus L1, L2 is how much?
25/9.
Okay. Right. You can find out the values of L1, L2.
Sir.
Yes.
If L2 is replaced by 25/9 upon L2, then sir, two values of L1 is obtained.
What are those?
Sir, first is 7.63
and 0.36.
What is the first one?
72 plus minus 65.45.
What is the first value? What is the first one?
Sir, 7.63 and the second one is
0.36. Yeah, correct. See here, one value will get some arbitrary value, right? Okay, so when you're finding the roots for L2, so what is the possible values of L2 you obtained? So one may be greater than 10 value, something like that you obtained, or one may be negative value. Agree?
Yes, sir.
So what are the roots you obtained?
The same roots.
Sir, the second root is equivalent to L2, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Second root is equivalent to L2.
Okay, that's fine then. Okay, right. Sometimes what will happen? So you will get, if you are finding the roots, sometimes it may be greater than 10, or sometimes if you have negative roots. So that means you need to exclude that. Okay. Yeah. So note down another one. Note down another problem. So these are the answers. So this L1 and this is L2. A ferromagnetic ring of cross-sectional area
or a ferromagnetic
ring of cross sectional area 800 millimeter square, a ferromagnetic ring of cross sectional area A equal to 800 millimeter square, and the mean radius 170 mm, and the mean radius 170 mm. Mean radius of that ring is 170 mm. It has two windings connected in series. It has two windings connected in series. Right. So one is with 500 turns. One is with 500 turns and the another one is with 700 turns. One is with 500 turns and the other one is with 700 turns. If the relative permeability is 1200, if the relative permeability is 1200, calculate self-inductance of each coil. Calculate self-inductance of each coil. Calculate self-inductance of each coil. And mutual inductance of and mutual inductance if K equal to 0.8, calculate self-inductance of each coil. That's the first question. Second one, calculate mutual inductance if coefficient of coupling K equal to 0.8, if coefficient of coupling K equal to 0.8. Also calculate the total inductance of the circuit. Also calculate the total inductance of circuit. Also calculate the total inductance of circuit. Total inductance of circuit. When the coils are connected in cumulative, when the coils are connected in cumulative and in differential. When the coils are connected in cumulative and in differential.
But the length of the two coils is not given, or are they equally surrounded around the ring, sir?
So that is equally surrounded. You can assume that they're the magnetic path, right? So this entire thing will comes under the magnetic path, the entire circumference.
Like 700 turn ring is occupying half of the ring, and the 500 turn coil is occupying other half.
Sir? It's not like this, right? If this is the right, we already say that some connection is there. It may be cumulative connection or differential connection. See here, if this is the case. Okay. So when you're calculating the magnetic path, you need to consider entire this will be the length of the circuit, magnetic circuit. Okay. You need not completely occupy that.
mutual inductance 0.23, sir.
Inductance is
mutual inductance is 0.23 and L1 and
0.23.
Yes, sir. And when they are connected in cumulative manner, we get 1.33, sir.
No, those are wrong.
Sir, L1 is 0.282.
L1 is 0.282. You are correct.
Sir, I am okay, sir. L1 is 0.277.
One is 0.55, sir.
0.277.
Like that. What is L2?
0.115.
0.55. 2, yeah, correct. So what is M?
Zero point three nine five.
No. Is it 0.32?
Zero point 0.319 I got.
Yeah, both are more or less same. No? So how to solve this? The first one is you need to calculate the inductance, right? Self-inductance L1 and L2. So what is the formula for self-inductance? If you know the number of turns, so that is N1 square by S. So this is also N2 square by S. So S is common for both, right? Because it is connected to the same magnetic core. So that is S is common. So what is the S? So S is L by mu naught. So what is L? So radius is given, right? So that means 2 pi into 170 into 10 to the power of minus 3, right? Millimeters. So mu naught, so 4 pi into 10 to the power of minus 7 into mu r, so that's 1200. So this is 800 a naught into 10 to the power of minus 6 if you convert this into meters. So how much you got? So it will be somewhere around 8.85 into 10 to the power of 5. What is the answer? So this is L1 and L2, right? So from that you can calculate M value. So from that you can calculate for L equivalent, for cumulative case and for differential case.
So 1.467 is for cumulative circuit, L equivalent.
Okay. That you can do it, right? So next we move to the other one. So when inductances with mutual when coupled inductances are connected in parallel, when coupled inductances are connected in parallel, so let us assume that we have circuit something like this. Right, so this current I is flowing here. So let us assume this I1, so this I2 is flowing here. So here assume that the dots are placed here. This is one dot and this is the other dot. So these dots will indicate the polarity of the EMF that induced with the other coil. Clear? So in this circuit, right, we want to calculate the total inductance. So this is equal to, right, so let us assume this is L1 and this is L2. So this is L equivalent. So there is a mutual inductance between these two, that is M. Clear? So we need to calculate L equivalent for this setup. Right. So we have this relation I equal to I1 plus I2, right? So if we differentiate this one, di by dt, so that is equal to di1 by dt plus di2 by dt. So let us assume that, so this is the EMF induced, so that is E. Right, so now tell me, so what is the induced EMF in the first coil?
L1 into di by dt.
L1 into?
Di1 by dt, sir.
Plus? What is its mutual inductance due to the current flowing in I2?
Sir, M into di1 by dt.
Plus sign or minus sign?
Plus sign,
right. So yeah. Because this is positive, so that means the induced EMF, so the other dot, so that is also positive, M into di I2 by dt.
Yes, sir.
Okay. If the dot is placed somewhere here, something like this, so what is the thing, what will happen? So instead of plus, minus, you will get minus.
Minus.
Okay. So this is equal to, so now tell me with respect to this circuit.
L2 into di1 by dt.
Agree? So we'll do some exercise. We are bringing the I1 by dt terms one side, right? And di2 by dt other terms. So what is he left with? So what you will get here? L1 minus M, right? M.
Yes,
sir. So we're here. So that is L2 minus M.
Minus M.
So that is into di2 by dt. So in other words, so di1 by dt, so this is equal to L2 minus M by L1 minus M into di2 by dt. So let us assume that, so this is equation one. Right? So substitute here, so let us assume this is equation one, for example, and this is equation two. So now substitute equation 2 in 1, equation 2 in 1. So what you left, so what you will get? So that means di by dt equal to di1 by dt, right? So this entire thing will be replaced, right? So will it be like this? L2 minus M by L1 minus M plus 1 into di2 by dt. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Agree. So let us assume that. So this is the third equation. So this is L equivalent, right? Okay. So here this is induced EMF. So this entire thing, whatever this we obtained, right? This one, this induced EMF. So here also we have some induced EMF, right? So this induced EMF is same. So what is that induced EMF? If you equate this one, so E equal to, right? So L1, so this D1 by DT plus M into DI2 by DT, so which is equal to, so what exactly is equal to L equivalent into DI by DT. Agree? If this is the current I. Agree?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
L equivalent into DI by DT. I will write this L equivalent in the other side. Right. So now we have one equation, so which is equation 2, right? So now substitute in place of this DI by DT, right? Let us assume that, say this is equation 4. So substitute equation 2 in 4, right? Equation 2 in 4. So what you left, L equivalent into DI by DT equal to, right? So substitute DI by, what you have, DI1 by DT. So we have this DI1 by DT, right? So substitute that. So what you will get? Is it like this L1 into L2 minus M by L1 minus M plus M D I2 by DT. Is it correct? Agree?
Yes, sir. That is last step, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Last step, sir. L equivalent into DI by DT means L1, DI by DT, this one, no, sir, in equation number 3, no, sir, DI by DT means.
Yeah.
But you have written here differently.
So this is the one we are substituting, right?
Okay, sir.
Is this correct?
Yes, sir, sir.
Is this correct?
Yes,
sir.
Sir.
Okay. So from this, so what is DI by DT? So this entire thing, so 1 by L equivalent. Okay. So L1 into L2 minus M by L1 minus M plus M into DI2 by DT. So let us assume that. So this is equation 4, 5. Let us assume this is equation 5. So if you notice equation 3 and 5, so what do you understand? So both are indicating DI by DT, right? Agree? Agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so can we equate that? If you equate equation 3 and 5, 3 and 5, if you equate.
So could you go to the previous question, previous page, sir? One second.
Yeah, I will. So we can equate these two, right?
Yes, sir, thank you.
So what, yeah. So what is the first one? So that means the coefficients are same, right? So that means L2 minus M by L1 minus M plus 1. This is equal to 1 by L equivalent into L1. L2 minus M, L1 minus M, L2 minus M, L1 minus M. Plus M. Right. So from this, you can calculate L equivalent.
it in equation 3 there are di1 by dt, and in equation 5 there is di2 by dt.
No, no, this is di2 by dt only, right?
Okay, okay, okay.
Di2 by dt.
I got L1 L2 minus M square by L1 plus L2 minus 2M.
What?
Yes, sir.
I got M is equal, L equivalent is equal to L1 L2 minus M square by L1 plus L2 minus 2M, sir.
L1 my L1 L2 minus M square by
minus L1 plus L2 minus 2M.
L1 plus L2 minus 2M.
L1 plus L2 minus
2M.
2M, right?
Sir.
Just simple thing, right? So this is for cumulative thing, right? So what is for differential thing? So what is the change in differential thing? So instead of this plus, so this is the sign change, right? So if it is a differential thing, so instead of this term is minus and this term is also minus. So we have this current, right? So this is minus and this is minus. If you do that, so you will get some L equivalent equal to L1 L2 minus M square by L1 plus L2 plus 2M you will get. Clear?
Yes.
Right. So we can have some problems on this one, so that I will send you. You have any questions?
Sir?
Yeah.
Yes?
Sir, how can differential coupling in parallel appears?
Mm-hmm.
Yesterday's problem, sir, you have given on problem regarding.
Yeah, yeah.
I got wrong, sir. Can you tell me the way?
What is yesterday's problem?
So two coils A and B having 12,500
turns. Yeah, we'll come. No, no, we'll come back to. Someone has asked some question.
How will the differential coupling of parallel connection looks like? Can you draw that, sir?
It's difficult to draw. Only thing is that, so the assumption is that the dot is placed here. Okay, in a large circuit, you never know so how they are actually connected. Okay, no? Right. For example, if a large circuit is there, for a bigger circuit, say it is having a very large number of inductances are, which are all connected. So in that case, you may encounter that. That the probability of this differential coupling is very small. So he never know so which current is positive and which current is negative. If you have something like if you have sources here, okay. So in that case, you may get. Yeah, someone is asked something. Yesterday's problem, right?
Yesterday's problem, sir. 12,500 and 16,000 tons.
Just a minute. Just a minute. So we have two coils of 12,500 and that is the one, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is the first one we need to calculate?
Mutual inductance.
Mutual inductance, self inductance, we need to calculate, right? So first thing is, so the data is given as, so N1 is having number of 12,500 turns is there, and N2, so that is 16,000 electrons are there, right? Okay, 60% of the flux produced in coil A linked with coil B. 60% of flux produced in coil A, so that is linked with coil B. Okay, so it is found that a 5 ampere current in coil A produces flux of 0.6 milliweber, right? A 5 ampere current, so that is producing 0.6 milliweber flux. So that means what we understood, the same thing, the same 5 ampere current that is producing 0.8 milliweber flux in coil 1, and this is coil 2. Okay. So flux per ampere in coil 1, what is flux per ampere in coil 1? So what is the amount of flux? That is 0.6 into 10 to the power of minus 3, number of, so that is current, right? So that is 5 ampere. So it will be 0.12. Okay. Similarly,
right. Sir, in the number of turns also we have to do now, sir. In self-inductance. We have to multiply it with the number of turns also, sir.
Not required. We are measuring just flux per ampere, right?
No,
so
sir.
This is the flux per ampere. Okay.
Okay, sir.
This is the flux per ampere. So this is right. So among this 0.62, only 60% is linked with coil B. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that means the flux, right? So flux per ampere linked with coil B is, so how much it is? 0.12 into 0.6. So that is 0.072.
Yes, sir.
So now you tell me what is M? So this much of flux, so that is linked with coil B, right? Okay. So this much of flux per ampere.
2 into 0.072.
So 0.072 right, into its number of turns in second winding. So that is 16,000. So how much it is? So 15 millihenry. So that is the mutual inductance.
Okay, sir. One by one.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
So here, the flux per ampere, the rate of change of flux per ampere, right? So that is 0.12 you got. So among that, 60% is linked with the second coil. Right. So from the definition of this mutual inductance, this is arrived. So M equal to the flux that linked with the coil 2 into its number of turns.
Sir, then for coefficient of coupling, we have one result that
M, right? So flux linkages, flux linkages per current, right?
Current, sir.
Okay. What is flux linkage? Flux per phi into I into number of turns.
Okay.
So we calculated phi I, so which is linked with the coil B, and the number of turns, that is N, that is 16,000 in this particular case.
Okay.
What is the second question?
Coefficient of coupling.
Sir.
Yes. How to calculate? So we have calculated the coefficient of coupling. We must know the values of L1, L2. What is the formula for L1? N1, I1. Sorry.
By phi 1.
So N1. No.
I1 by phi
1. N1, phi 1 by I1, I1, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what is N1?
12,500, sir.
12,500. So what is phi 1?
0.6.
0.6 current 5 amperes. So what is L2? N2 phi 2 by I2, right? So this 16,000 into 0.8 divided by I2. So that is also 5 amperes.
Sir.
From that you can calculate the value of coefficient of coupling by using M by square root L into C. Okay. L1 into L2. Yes,
sir.
Yes,
sir. In this step to calculate the mutual inductance, sir, how to define 15 millihenry when 16,000 is multiplied with?
So we have formula for mu, right? So we have in one of the definition one K one into, if you remember that. Yeah. So this is this one. You remember this?
Yes,
so M equal to N2 into K1, phi1 by I1. So you are calculated phi1 by I1 in the coil 1, right? So K1, so how much, what is K1 value? Only 60% of that flux is linked to the
second coil.
Second coil, right? So that is 60, that is 0.6 into N2. That is the same thing we applied here.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So any further questions?
Sir?
Yes.